Hey guys, welcome to update number three. I've done a lot of work this weekend. If you look behind me, you can see the structures up. I got some foam on top. Still got to get some more materials, finish what I do have. But that's where I'm at. I'm closer to running trains and closer to track, so that's the fun part. Maybe when I get a little bit of this done and up to this corner, I'll probably lay out a little bit of track just to get an idea of what I want to do, and then coming around, so hopefully in the next month, by March, be able to run a train. So stay tuned. I'll show you everything I did this weekend, and I hope you guys have a good weekend. Hope everything's going well for you guys, and I'll see you on your guys' update in the next update I do. Thanks.
Okay, guys, been working on the layout here today a little bit. Got a good start. Got the three modules together, bolted, tight, happy, a little bit off on the back part. This is the back, just a little bit off, not sure why, but the front down there is on the ground. It's level, it's solid, it matches up perfect, which is fine. You're going to see that first for a while before I put a fascia on and anything else, and that's important. The back will be backdropping me, and you'll see that. So as long as the front's good and everything lines up, and it does, I'm going to make the legs, which I'm in the process of making now, 43 inches. Comes a little bit above my waist. I don't have to bend over. It works for me, the model railroad. So that's a good height for me. It's 5 inches taller than my last one, which is good. So I'm happy about that. That's an adjustment I wanted to make. This is very lightweight, which is another thing I wanted. I can move this easily. So that's good. So right now I've got legs cut. I'm still in the process of doing it. I've got one more board to cut. Then I'm out of the 2x3s I'm gonna use for legs for now. I have to get some more. That I might continue cutting the modules and just seeing how far I can get with those. There's the foam. I have to put that on the top. First, once I get the legs on and get that cut, I have to move this stuff all the way and over to this side for now and clean this up so I can put those modules back here and get the foam on top. That'll clear up a lot of space. I can put some of this back under it, because eventually I'm going to build a storage shelf underneath both sections, and also build a nice shelf for my Digitrack system. Right now I run the Zephyr. In the near future, sometime this year, I want to get a DB 210, I think, just to boost, and maybe eventually go LocoNet, and that would be nice. So that's what I'm working on right now. So stay tuned, and we'll see what happens with this mess. And we'll see how that module turns out. Okay, guys, got the legs in. This is setting a little bit crooked because my floor is not level, but top should be. I think I'm gonna still need two legs in here, just because I'm not, it's a little more sturdy, but I feel better with that. Once I get some more wood to do that, I want to continue on down. But there's three modules. The legs are pretty solid. They're screwed in there. These ends, I may put a cross piece across here just for support, just sturdy them up. And maybe in the ones that I put in here, probably too. These are staggered to lift up this part. But guys, that's it. I'm close, a bit closer. I gotta scooch back in the corner there, but yes, closer. Now I just gotta start building on the other side and then move my stuff back under here, so which is fine. There's more storage. This is 48 inches high. It comes just above my waist. I come up here and you see I can stand here, and whoop, that's about where my waist is. So still good, very good. I can reach across to the back, no problem. Get on a stool a little bit, maybe if I have to do some track work or something, not a big deal. Not standing on it, not sitting on it, none of that I had to do on my other layout. This is light to move. I was able to move it. If it was my other layout, I'd probably break my back trying to move it. So this is a good start. Very happy. May have to drill a hole here for feeder, for a bus line. I think this is just going to be the curve coming over a mountain here. But the holes are here for the rest of the way I'm down. And I'll have to drill a hole here for a bus line as well. Or maybe in here, we'll see. We'll see, depending on where the track is. So that's it, guys. So let's see if I can get the top on here, and we'll hopefully put that in.
Hey guys, I've got a piece of foam here cut. This fits nice on this end. Oops, sorry. Just gotta trim off a little bit here that's overlapped. I'm gonna cut it right here on this seam. I wanted to make a 6-foot section come out here. Unfortunately, I came up short. So not a big deal. I'm gonna reuse this section anyway. Hopefully I can make it fit somewhere. If not, we can definitely repurpose that on landscaping, especially when I make a mountain over here in this corner. Bench work turned out good. This is all nice and right here even. You can kind of see here how this is nice and pretty much even here. It's a divot there, I don't know what that is. But even, it's still very solid. The legs are screwed in both sides, this way and then from this way. It's solid, solid, solid. Very lightweight compared to my last layout. I could pick this up and move it no problem if I had to, so which is something I wanted to do. Plenty of storage underneath the height, plenty of storage. That's what I got to do here in a little bit, move this over. So hopefully I get the foam on, fixed, then maybe start on some more modules next week going this way. This all stuff I got to clean up, put underneath. Going this way until I run out of materials. I probably can make 2 to 3 more modules. I do have legs for another one, so I may put them together, put the legs on them and put it up and attach it to this side, and just not put anything on it, and then come back, put my legs on, and then continue down, right about down to where this stuff is here is about how far I want to go. So I'm probably going to need 3 more pieces of foam. So that's where I'm at progress-wise on the layout. You guys, I hope you had a good weekend. Hope you're enjoying things. And we'll catch you on the next update. Thanks.